Homestuck is procedural. Sure, the game it's about has the same kind of randomly generated terrain that you can find in games like Minecraft, but it has a leg up over them in terms of generation that they could never hope to achieve. It has a bar so high that most people think it's strictly impossible. SBEPIS contains every item in the universe, as well as every combination of those items through the game's alchemy system, all based on 6 bytes of data. And it's up to me to make this impossible item generation possible. I'm JD Draconovics from Dragon and Fox Collective, and I'm making a video game based on Homestuck. Alchemy in Homestuck works by representing items as an 8-digit base 64 code, or alternatively as a handful of 48 holes punched in a card, or as a lathed dowel. This information, when fed through the appropriate machinery, allows players to spawn items into existence or combine information together to create new items. All of this works out to having about 300 trillion items possible in SBEPIS, but considering this is supposed to encompass every single object in the universe, including any combination of objects, it's not that many. But it's theorized in-universe that there are hidden mechanics besides just item codes. Technological mind reading is a canon mechanic in Homestuck, so I personally assume it has something to do with the player's intentions, but I can't just read minds, so I'm going to have to toss that idea to the curb. If we're talking about just the item codes, I haven't seen anyone create completely procedural item generation yet. The simplest implementation is to just make a handful of items and give them all static codes and throw away any invalid codes as seen in Mindstuck and Project Overseer, although Overseer at least lets you make up your own items too. Tablestuck has the most gamey implementation, where instead of holes, it only uses the code digits, and Alchemy takes the higher or lower digits from 2 codes, which gives the results a combination of the item type and stats from either item. Then there's the Genesis project, where an alchemy just increases an item's stats and gives it a gibberish name based on its ingredients, but also carries over tags from its ingredients, which determine special properties. So none of these games actually procedurally generate new items. Probably the closest features what I'm looking for would be TGP's tags, except they need to be a little more involved. Item cards have 48 holes punched in them, right? What if each hole was a bit that represented a tag the resulting item had? Then, as long as you can describe everything in the universe through 48 bits, you would have a basis for alchemical combination. Say, for example, you had 2 bits, handled and pointed. An item with only the handled bit would be a stick, and an item with only the pointed bit would be a spike, but combining them together, you'd get an item that's both handled and pointed, which would be a spear. This sounds pretty Homestucky. The downside though is that there's a second way to combine these items, by making something without the bits of either item, that's not handled nor pointed. For this completely empty item, SBEPIS reserves a green plastic cube called a perfectly generic object. So it's not a perfect system, but it's a good start and I've already got an idea or two to mitigate it, but that'll have to be in a future update. So we've got the simplest implementation down, static recipes. A handle alchemically ored with a spike gives you a spear. So what about items that don't exist for a combination of bits? Say we added another bit called weighted, where a rock is weighted and a hammer is weighted and handled. What if we combined a hammer and a spike to make something that's handled, weighted, and pointed? In Homestuck, this would probably make something like a hammer with a head replaced by a spike, which sounds really cool for a weapon. But I really don't want to custom make something like this, because if my solution was just to add custom items manually, then I would have to start making trillions of them, and I don't think I have the energy to do that. Now we get to the procedural generation part. How would I make a hammer with a head as a spike in real life? Obviously, I would just take a hammer, pull off its head, and put a spike on it. Problem solved. This should be easy to make in code, right? First, let me stick all of the items I have currently in a list, from most bits to least bits. I'm just gonna pick the first item that has bits that will work with result bits. The first item on the list is a hammer, which is handled and weighted. These bits match our item, so it'll work for our starting point. Now we'll need to get the spike from the list somehow. If I just tried to pick an item like I did the first time, I'll just get the hammer again. Even if I skip the hammer, I'll get the spear, which isn't what I want right now. I want to prefer to use items that don't share bits with what I already have, so I'll make a scoring system that rewards new bits and penalizes used bits. The hammer has 2 used bits, so it scores -2. The spear has 1 new bit and 1 used bit, so it scores 0. The spike, finally, has 1 new bit, so it scores a 1. This is the high score on our list, so we'll use it. Now we'll just configure each base item to have something I can delete and replace with something else, and I'll do that with a hammer and spike, and voila! Spiky hammer. Now we can make randomly generated stuff. It's just not very Homestucky in all regards. Like, when John combines his green pogo ride with a hammer, both ways the result is at the very least green. This doesn't really make sense with our alchemy system, so we're missing something. Maybe TGP was onto something with her tags. We could make a secondary system of tags separate from the bits that always get added together, regardless of which kind of alchemy the bits use. But we have to put this information somewhere, and we can't put it on the holds of a punched card. Maybe we can put it in the card. According to Homestuck, each of these item cards that get hole punched can already optionally contain items in a kind of inventory system. So what if we use the tags of the item in the card when generating a new item? If I add a green tag to the perfectly generic object, now I can punch the bits for hammer into the card containing a PGO to get a green hammer. It's not exactly like Homestuck, but I already said that Homestuck isn't perfect, and this is close enough. Now that we can have arbitrary information carried through alchemy, we can make all sorts of custom objects based on, say, posters of media or photos of celebrities. This splits the alchemy process into two halves, one for creating a generic item type through bits, and one for customizing the item through tags. That's more Homestucky item generation, even if it's not strictly canon. So thank you for watch- Oh, wait, I just thought of a generic item that's handled and weighted and pointed. A meat tenderizer. Darn, and I really like the spiky hammer. Well, I wonder if... If I added a tenderizer, then the only thing that would change in the alchemy process is that it would start with the tenderizer instead of the hammer. So the important step here is changing which item you start with, right? I could theoretically add extra information to tell the alchemy process to start with a hammer instead of the tenderizer. Oh, that's just another tag. Now with this tag, alchemy would start generating the type of item already in the card, so it can start with a recognizable item type. Now we can make the tenderizer, the spiky hammer, and a heavy spear all with the same code. So in total, this gives us a way to procedurally generate items exponentially. Right now, I have 6 bits for 64 possible generic items, times a dozen or so item bases, a golden tag, and a perfectly generic tag. This is definitely enough for a proof of concept for now, at least until they add usable weapons and not just physics objects. A brand new update of the game, Act 1, Act 4, is getting released alongside this devlog, showcasing the new alchemy system. You can pick it up from the GitHub or from the Dragon and Fox Discord server linked in the description. If you want to get notified when I finish weapons and other updates, subscribe to DNFC and ring the bell. Also in the description is the GitHub for the project, because this entire thing is going to be free and open source, so anyone can contribute to it. Because it's free, you can buy us a hot chocolate with Ko-fi or subscribe to our Patreon below to support us. Thanks to our Thaumerger tier patron, Concours. I'm JD Draconomics, thank you for watching.